Welcome back, everyone. So this episode, we're going to see if we can use the punches we made in last episode to make a railroad spike bottle opener thing. And if we have time after that, I'm going to see what I can do about making a corkscrew out of bottle opener. Thanks for watching. Sophisticated tool here. Off on the twist until after I finish the punch next time, because it's just making it difficult. Finally. This is the most awkward piece of metal ever, but finally got it to shear, so. Ta-da! I did just realize that this is a reverse screw, so we gotta turn left in order to get it to actually bite into a cork. Oops. Thank you. Alright, thank you so much for watching, everyone. I figured the best way to end this video is by testing out the fruits of our labor, so let's give it a go. Wait.
Let's do this!
Dirty Smith have a copyright on opening bottles by an anvil?
Well, to avoid a possible lawsuit, I'm gonna go ahead and open it by a belt sander. Alright, let's give her a go. Eat the works.
Let's do this!
So I live in the US and am currently 20 years of age, so as a virgin substitute to wine, I have this Sicuramente non acqua e tintura. If you speak Italian, leave your translation down below. Let me know how I did. So I'll bring you in for a close-up, and we'll get screwing counterclockwise, because I messed up.
Going in. I should probably mention that this cork was assembled by me out of a sheet of cork rolled up like a Swiss roll.
Alright, Todd from the future here. I realize that this isn't really going to cut it for practical use after a little bit of finagling. One, you turn it the wrong way to get it to bite, which is just not how it's supposed to work. And I also really didn't thin the coil material itself down thin enough to make it go easy on the cork. So I redid it, and this is what I got now. So just thinner coil material, and each segment of the coil is much closer together, so it's a tighter thread, I guess. I did film a time lapse of forging this guy, but while I was transferring the file from my memory card to my computer, I had some type of a memory corruption issue. Alright, everybody, thank you for watching. Sorry again about that footage loss. I'm just glad you got to see what it's supposed to look like and do. I'm gonna try to add a little redundancy to my offloading procedure for future videos. Speaking of which, there's more coming soon, so make sure you're subscribed and do it. Do it now. Do what he said. Alright. Till next time.